On this flight, we will depart from Orlando International Airport and climb to 16,000 feet. We will then practice intercepting inbound and outbound courses from a fix. Let's first practice going directly to a fix, such as when ATC assigns the following.
737, clear direct to Palm Beach.
We simply type PBI into the scratch pad and enter it as the active waypoint by clicking on the top left key. The keys are referred to by which side they are on and are numbered from top to bottom. So the top left key is referred to as L1. Before executing the change, we check that it is what we want by checking the navigation display. We then check LNAV is the active mode and that we are turning towards the assigned waypoint. TRV is no longer needed and can be deleted to clean up the box. We monitor the aircraft as it turns towards PBI. It is good practice to center the heading bug when established on a course. We have now practiced commanding a turn directly to a waypoint. Next, we will practice intercepting a particular inbound course to a waypoint, rather than proceeding direct. This would be required for an ATC clearance such as
737, fly heading 140, and intercept the 360 radial to Palm Beach.
The first action is to set the heading bug to 140 and select heading mode to turn the aircraft. We check the PFD to ensure heading mode is active. We enter PBI in L1 and type 180 in the scratch pad, the reciprocal of the radial assigned, as we are flying towards the fix. We then enter the value by pressing R6. We check the dash line on the ND display, depicts the 360 radial, before executing the command. We select LNAV mode and check it is the active mode. The aircraft will remain on the 140 heading until it intercepts the 360 radial. Note, when intercepting a course and more than 3 nautical miles from the radial, the intercept heading must be 90 degrees or less in relation to the inbound course, and the intercept must also occur before the active waypoint for LNAV to engage. As we approach the 360 radial, LNAV turns the aircraft and joins the radial. Once the aircraft is established on the inbound course, we center the heading bug. Let's practice some more.
737, you are cleared direct Pahokee.
This time follow along with the video. Very good, PHK was entered as the active waypoint, then the course was checked before the change was executed. LNAV was confirmed engaged, and the aircraft monitored in the turn. Let's practice one more.
737, fly heading 230 and join the Pahokee 090 radial.
Once again, we set the assigned heading and flew it in heading mode, then entered the waypoint and the intercept course, confirmed it was correct, then executed the change and engaged LNAV. We verified LNAV was active and watch for the aircraft to intercept the radial when it gets there. As the aircraft approaches the leg, LNAV commands a turn to intercept the radial. and as always, we center the heading bug. Let's try intercepting an outbound radial. Here is a typical clearance.
737, fly heading 300 to join the Lakeland 340 radial outbound.
We turn the heading bug to 300 and select heading mode. Then check the mode is active on the PFD. As Lakeland is already our active waypoint, we click on L1 and transfer it to the scratch pad. Now we add the assigned radial immediately afterwards. This is followed by a forward slash and a value representing an arbitrary distance such as 50 miles. We transfer this to the second line by pressing L2. The next step is to press L2 again to transfer the entry back to the scratch pad and press L1 to put it on the first line. Then we make the intercept course big by pressing R6. After checking the result, we can execute the modification and delete the leg that's no longer required. LNAV can now be selected, and we check that it becomes the active mode. The aircraft will now fly 300 until it intercepts the outbound course. Today we have practiced proceeding directly to fixes and intercepting particular radials both inbound and outbound. Subscribe for notification of our future videos.